Dear students, welcome. This is our fourth class on statics. Let us start. First, I shall solve this problem. These three problems. Let us try to solve this problem. What is it? If the magnitude of the resultant of two concurrent forces P and Q be equal to 1/3 of the sum of their magnitudes, prove that the angle between the forces is this. Two forces are given, P and Q. Their magnitudes will be equal to P and Q. And their resultant is 1/3 the sum of their magnitudes. This means their resultant of their magnitudes will be 1/3 into P plus Q. What is the angle between that forces? Very easy. Solution. Solution number 15. If the magnitude of the resultant will be equal to angle between the two forces, let alpha be the angle between the two forces. Be the angle between the two forces. Forces P and Q. Let alpha be the angle between the two forces P and Q. Therefore, according to the question, resultant is equal to 1/3 of the sum of their magnitudes. Resultant is equal to this. Use the formula R square equal to P square plus Q square plus 2SPQ cos alpha. Should be equal to P square plus Q square plus 2SPQ cos alpha. PQ cos alpha. We have to find alpha in terms of P and Q. This means P plus Q 1/9 P plus Q whole square, P square plus Q square plus twice PQ cos alpha. This means 1/9 P square plus Q square plus twice PQ. This is equal to P square plus Q square plus twice PQ cos alpha. Is it? This means 1/9 minus 1 P square plus Q square. Plus 2/9 PQ should be equal to 2 PQ cos alpha. Should be equal to 2 PQ cos alpha. This means minus 1/8 it will be, not 1/8. Minus 8/9 P square plus Q square. Plus 2/9 PQ. This is equal to 2 PQ cos alpha. 2 will be cancelled. This means minus 4 P square plus Q square plus PQ should be equal to 9 PQ cos alpha. 9 PQ cos alpha should be equal to 9 PQ cos alpha. What we have done here, first divide the equation by 2 and then multiply by 9. If you divide it by 2 and multiply by 9, you will get minus 4 P square plus Q square from this term, and you will get simply P by PQ, and from this term you will get 9 PQ. This means cos alpha equal to PQ minus 4 P square plus Q square divided by 9 PQ divided by 9 PQ. This means alpha equal to cos inverse PQ minus 4 times of P square plus Q square divided by 9 PQ. Divided by 9 PQ. Therefore, the angle between the two forces is cos inverse PQ minus 4 P square plus Q square divided by 9 PQ. Divided by 9. Therefore, we have solved the equation number 1. Today's equation number 1, and as a whole, that question number 1, and as a whole, it is the question number 15. Now, let us try to solve the question number 16. Today's question number 2. What is it? Two forces P and Q acting on a particle are inclined at an angle alpha. Prove that their resultant turn through an angle phi given by these when they intersect their positions. You see, two forces P and Q acting on a particle are inclined at an angle alpha. Prove that their resultant turn through an angle phi given by these when they intersect their positions. When they intersect their positions. Let us try to solve this problem. Suppose this is a force P. And Q. Suppose this is Q. P force and Q force. This is P and this is Q. This is P and this is Q. Yes. These two forces acting at a point O. Suppose P and Q are two forces acting at a point O. Suppose OA and OB, OA vector and OB vector represents the forces P and Q respectively. Therefore, by the law of parallelogram of forces, if two forces acting at a point be represented in magnitude and directions by two adjacent sides of a parallelogram, then their diagonal will represent the resultant of the two forces. Therefore, by the law of parallelogram, what is their diagonal? This is the, suppose the diagonal, let me write the diagram properly. Suppose this is OC is the diagonal. OC is the diagonal. This OC diagonal will represent the resultant of the two forces P and Q. Resultant of the two forces P and Q. Resultant. Suppose this the resultant is R. Suppose the angle between the two forces P and Q is alpha, it is given in the equation. It is given in the equation. Now, the positions of P and Q are interchanged. The positions of P and Q are interchanged. When we take the position this one, takes the position this, see, suppose this is D, and OB takes the position here, E here. Then, by the law of parallelogram of forces, let me write the diagram properly. Suppose this is by the law of parallelogram of forces, the diagonal of this parallelogram will be equal to this, OF. This will be equal to resultant In this case, this will be the resultant. OF will represent the resultant of the forces P and Q. Then, according to the question, the resultant will turn through an angle phi. This means this angle will be equal to phi. This angle will be equal to phi. Now, what we should do? We should do a relation between this alpha, phi, p and q. Alpha, phi, p and q. This relation will be obtained. Let us proceed. How to solve this problem? Now, first let me write two forces acting at the point. Let the two forces P and Q acting at the point at O be represented in magnitude and direction by represented in magnitude and direction by the sides OA and OB by the sides OA and OB of the parallelogram OABC of the parallelogram OABC, therefore, by the law of parallelogram of forces, by the law of parallelogram of forces, the resultant of P and Q will be represented by the diagonal OC of the parallelogram. Forces. The resultant R vector C. The resultant R will be represented. Will be represented in magnitude and direction. And direction by the diagonal OC of the parallelogram OABC OABC. Instead of writing OABC, you may write OACB because OACB, the diagonal OC. Clear? By the law of parallelogram of forces, OC will represent the resultant of P and Q. Resultant of P and Q. Thus, we have written this. The angle between thus, what we have to retain, OA vector equal to P vector. OA, P, OB equal to Q vector. Also, OC equal to R. OC equal to R. Now, OB and AC. Now, OB is parallel to AC. OB equal to AC also. OB is equal to AC. Therefore, AC vector equal to OB, OB vector equal to Q. This will also represent, AC will also represent Q vector, Q force, the force Q. Up to this, I think it is clear. Now, the positions of P and Q are interchanged. This means, positions of P and Q are interchanged. This means, the force OA is shifted to their position. OB, OD, suppose OD. And the force OB has been shifted to the position OE. Now the positions of P and Q are interchanged. Now let the positions of P and Q are interchanged. Let us suppose there. The force P has been shifted to the to OB, OD. Let us suppose there. In this case, OD vector equal to P, OD vector is equal to P, also OE vector equal to Q, and OE vector equal to Q force. In the second case, OD vector equal to P and OE vector equal to D. Now, that this means, what does it mean? This means that the two forces P and Q are represented by the adjacent sides OD and OE. OD and OE of the parallelogram represented In magnitude and direction, you may write in magnitude and direction. This means that the two forces P and Q are represented in magnitude and direction by the adjacent sides OD and OE of the parallelogram. Parallelogram ODFE. ODFE. Therefore, they are resultant will be represented by the diagonal. Will be represented in magnitude and direction, represented in magnitude and direction by the diagonal OF of the parallelogram ODFE, right?
That is, in the second case, would the vector is this vector will represent the force P, OE will represent the force Q, therefore the diagonal OF will definitely represent their resultant. And in the first case, OC will represent the resultant this. Where are is the resultant of the forces P and Q? I think it is clear. Here you may write where R represents the resultant of, or R is the resultant of P and Q. You may write R is the resultant of P and Q. According to the question, resultant has turned through an angle phi. This means that COF, this angle will be equal to phi. According to the question, the resultant turned, originally the resultant was in the position OC, and in the second case, the resultant is OF. It has turned through an angle phi, therefore COF equal to phi. According to the question, COF, this angle equal to phi. This angle is equal to phi. This angle is equal. Now, let us suppose that in the first case, the resultant makes an angle theta with the direction of P, According to the question, let the resultant R, let in the first case, resultant R makes an angle theta. Angle theta with the direction of P. With the direction of the force P. That is COA equal to, that is COA, this angle is equal to theta. Clearly, FOD, this angle will be also theta. In the second case also, therefore, in the second case, yes, also FOD, this angle will be again theta. If this is theta, if the resultant makes an angle theta with the direction of P, COA, this is equal to theta. And in the second case, OD represents the force P. Therefore, this angle will be again theta. This angle is also theta. In the second case, FOD, this angle is also theta. Therefore, from the diagram, you see the diagram. Therefore, theta plus phi plus theta, this is equal to alpha. See the diagram. Theta plus phi plus theta, this is equal to the whole angle alpha. This means twice theta is equal to alpha minus phi. This means theta is equal to alpha minus phi divided by 2. Alpha minus phi divided by 2. Alpha minus phi divided by 2. Right? Now you see here. OCA, we shall consider that angle OCA. This angle is theta. COD, this angle will be equal to You notice this angle. This angle is equal to theta plus phi. Now, OD and AC are parallel, and OC is the transversal. Therefore, this angle is theta plus phi. What will be this angle? This angle will be again theta plus phi. Now, OB is parallel to AC. OB is parallel to AC. OB and OD represents the same. This is a OD is within the line OD. Therefore, OB you may write OD or OB is parallel to AC. OC is the transversal. OC intersecting. OC is the transversal. Means OC intersects it. Therefore, this angle will be equal to this angle. Therefore, BOC, this angle equal to OCA. OCA. This angle will be equal to this angle. Definitely, which what will be this angle? Theta plus phi by the diagram. It is theta plus phi. Clear? These angles are called alternate angle. Alternate. You may write in the bracket alternate angle. This angle is equal to this angle. These two lines are parallel. This angle. What is this angle? Equal to this angle. Like that. These two sides are parallel. This is transversal, therefore this angle will be equal to this angle. Now consider the triangle OCA. Now consider the triangle OCA. Consider the triangle OCA. Now consider the triangle. OCA. OA divided by sine of OCA. This is equal to AC divided by sine of COA. What formula has been applied in any triangle ABC? A by small a by sine a equal to small b by sine b equal to small c by sine c. In any triangle ABC, A by sine a equal to b by sine b equal to c by sine c. This formula has been applied in any triangle. In any triangle ABC. A by sine A equal to B by sine B equal to C by sine C, that formula has been applied. Theta is equal to alpha minus, theta is equal to alpha minus phi divided by 2. Now, this means OA is P, OA, P in the first case, OA is equal to P, and OC, AC, this is equal to Q. Sine of OCA, this is theta plus phi. This is sine of theta. Now, theta is equal to alpha minus phi divided by 2. Sine of alpha minus phi divided by 2 plus phi. This is equal to Q divided by sine of alpha minus phi divided by 2. Theta is equal to alpha minus phi divided by 2. This implies P divided by sine. Alpha minus phi plus twice phi divided by 2 equal to Q by sine alpha minus phi by 2. Alpha minus phi divided by 2. This means P divided by sine alpha plus phi by 2
equal to q by sine alpha minus phi divided by q.
Why is it not removing properly?
Now see here. See the question. P minus Q divided by P plus Q. Therefore, you should use the component we are dividing to P by Q equal to sine alpha plus phi divided by 2. Sine alpha minus phi by 2. Now applying component rule and dividing rule again. Applying component rule and dividing rule. We get. Applying component rule and dividing rule. We get. P minus Q by P plus Q should be equal to sine alpha plus phi by 2 minus sine alpha minus phi by 2 sine alpha plus phi by 2 plus sine alpha minus phi divided by 2. This is equal to sine c minus sine d twice cos c plus d by 2. Into sine c minus d by 2. This is equal to twice cos alpha plus phi by 2 plus alpha minus phi by 2 into sine alpha plus pi by 2 minus alpha minus pi divided by 2. Divided by twice sine c plus sine d equal to twice sine c plus d by 2. Into cos c minus d by 2. What formula we have applied? Since sin c plus sin d, sin c plus sin d equal to twice sin c plus d by 2 cos c minus d by 2 sin c minus sin d, this is equal to twice cos c plus d by 2 sin c minus d by 2. This formula has been applied here. Here sin c plus sin d twice sin c plus d by 2 into cos c minus d by 2. Sin c minus sin d twice cos c plus d by 2 and sin into sin c minus d by 2. These two formula has been applied here. Now these two will be cancelled. These two will be cancelled. This means P minus Q by P plus Q should be equal to P minus Q by P plus Q equal to cos, here you see alpha by 2 plus phi by 2, alpha by 2 minus phi by 2 means plus phi by 2 minus phi by 2 will be cancelled. Alpha by 2 plus alpha by 2 will be equal to alpha, therefore it you will get cos of alpha by 2 plus alpha by 2 means alpha divided by 2. Cos of alpha divided by 2. And sine. This plus alpha by 2 minus alpha by 2 will be cancelled. Pi by 2 plus pi by 2 means pi. Also 2. Pi by 2. Here, this
alpha by 2 plus phi by 2 plus alpha by 2 minus phi by 2. This phi by 2 will be cancelled. You will get alpha by 2 plus alpha by 2, means alpha. Sin alpha by 2. Or this phi phi will be cancelled. No, not phi phi will be cancelled. This alpha alpha will be cancelled. Not phi. This alpha by 2 will be cancelled. You will get phi by 2 plus phi by 2, means phi divided by 2. Os phi by 2. Os phi by 2. You will get this one. Or, this means sin phi by 2 by cos phi by 2 equal to p minus q by p plus q. Sin alpha by 2 divided by cos alpha by 2. You get this one. This sin alpha by 2, take sin alpha by 2 here, cos alpha by 2 here, and in one side you write sin alpha by 2 is cos phi by 2. This one. This means it will be tan phi by 2 will be equal to p minus q by p plus q. Tan alpha by 2. Just we have proved this one. It is very easy. We have proved that tan phi by 2 equal to p minus q by p plus q tan alpha by 2. If the positions of p and q are interchanged, resultant turn through an angle phi, then the relation between these is tan phi by 2 equal to p minus q by p plus q tan alpha by 2, where alpha is the angle between the two forces p and q. Alpha is the angle between the two forces p and q. Now, what we have done? We have interchanged the positions of p and q. Then, the resultant will turn through an angle phi, where tan phi by 2 equal to p minus q by p plus q tan alpha by 2. Very interesting. Perhaps you have enjoyed this problem also. Now, come to the last problem. The question number 17. Now come to the question number 17. Let me first remove this one. Question number 17. I am going to solve the question number 17. What is it? The magnitudes of the resultant of P and Q. The magnitudes of the resultant of P and Q. P and R and Q and R are x, x and y respectively. When they act at the same angle, they act at the same angle. Suppose the angle is phi or the alpha or suppose the angle is alpha. Then two conditions are given here. Q is not equal to R and P plus Q plus R equal to 0. We shall use these two conditions. Q is not equal to R and P plus Q plus R equal to 0. Then we have to prove that X equal to Y. X equal to Y. Now, X equal to Y. Now, let alpha be the angle between the forces. Let solution number 17. Let alpha be the angle between the forces P and Q and R and P and R. P and R. According to the question, the resultant of P and Q is X. According to the question, X square equal to P and Q. P square plus Q square plus twice PQ cos alpha. Suppose this is number one. Also, resultant of P and R is also X. x square equal to p and r, resultant of p and r is also x. Use this. And resultant of q and r is y. Q and r, resultant of q and r is y.
Resultant of q and r is now, from 1 and 2, left sides are equal, x square, x square. From 1 and 2, from 1 and 2, left sides are equal. Therefore, right sides will also be equal. Equal to p square plus r square. Plus twice pr cos alpha. Now you see, P square will be cancelled. P square will be cancelled. This means Q square minus R square plus twice PQ minus twice PR cos alpha equal to zero. Take the
terms
in the right hand side to the left hand side. This means q minus r, q plus r into q minus r plus twice p q minus r cos alpha equal to 0. You will get this one. This means from these two terms q minus r is common. You will get q plus r plus twice p cos alpha equal to 0.
Now use the condition that q is not equal to r, means q minus r is not equal to 0. This means this term will be equal to 0. Now q is not equal to r, we shall use this condition. This means q minus r is not equal to 0. Therefore q plus r plus twice p cos alpha, this should be equal to 0. This means cos alpha should be equal to minus q plus r divided by twice p. Am I right? This is number 4. Cos alpha equal to this. Now 1 minus 3 implies, from 1 minus 3 you will get, now 1 minus 3 or 2 minus 3? Suppose 1 minus 3. Now 1 minus 3. 1 minus 3, this implies x square minus y square equal to, you will get p square plus q square plus twice pq cos alpha minus q square minus r square minus twice qr cos alpha. You will get this one. Now plus q square minus q square will be cancelled. This means which is equal to p square minus r square plus twice q into p minus r cos alpha. You will get this one. This means it is p plus r into p minus r plus twice q p minus r cos alpha. By 4 you may write q plus r by twice p by 4. Using 4 you will get this one. This means I am very sorry, twice q, it will be p minus r. It will be p minus r, not p minus q. Twice q is common, p minus r, in place of cos alpha, we have written this. By 4. Now, from these two terms, p minus r is, you may take p minus r common. You will get p plus r plus minus twice q divided by twice p q plus r. Right? Now these two will be cancelled. This is equal to p minus r. Also you may take 1 by p, you will get here p square plus pr minus q square minus qr. You will get this one. This is equal to 1 by p, p minus r, p square minus q square plus pr minus qr. Plus pr minus qr, you will get this one. This is equal to 1 by p, p minus r, p plus q into p minus q, plus r, p minus q, you will get this one. And this means, this means x square minus y square equal to, this means x square minus y square, this is equal to 1 by p, p minus r, p minus q is also common, p minus q also common, in the bracket you will get p plus q plus r, p plus q plus r. Now, use the second condition, p plus q plus r is also 0. This is equal to 0, since p plus q plus r equal to 0. P plus q plus r, this is equal to 0. This means x square minus y square equal to 0. This means x square equal to y square. Consequently, we will get x is equal to y. Prove that x is equal to y. We have proved that x is equal to y. Two conditions were given to us. Q is not equal to R, it has already been applied, and P plus Q plus R equal to 0. It has also it has also been applied here. Does X equal to Y? We have proved this question also. We have proved this also. Let us take some more problems. First, let me remove this one. Question number 18. Today's question number 4. Two forces P plus Q, P minus Q. The factor sign has not been given. This means that the magnitudes of the two forces are P plus Q and P minus Q. Make an angle twice alpha with one another, and their resultant makes an angle theta with bisector of the angle between them. With bisector of the angle between them. Suppose this angle, this force is P plus Q, and P minus Q, it is P minus Q in magnitude, in magnitude. This is their bisector, it is supposed bisector. Bisector of the forces, it, this angle is twice alpha. This angle is twice alpha. This means that this angle will be alpha and this angle will be also alpha. Because this is the bisector, it is alpha, it is also alpha. Obviously, P plus Q is greater than P minus Q. Therefore, the resultant direction of the resultant of the forces P plus Q and P minus Q will be nearer to P plus Q. Suppose this is the resultant. This is the resultant. R is the resultant. Resultant, suppose. It makes an angle theta with the bisector. This bisector, it makes an angle theta. Therefore, the resultant will make an angle. It is alpha, it is theta, therefore it is will make an angle alpha minus theta with the direction of the force P plus Q. Perhaps you understand this. You have understood this. Therefore, let us proceed. Let us proceed. We have written bisector, this bisectors. From diagram, this is the resultant, this is bisector, resultant makes an angle theta with the bisector. The resultant will make an angle alpha minus theta with the direction of the force P. Clearly, the resultant are of the forces. I have not given the vector sign. This means that the magnitude of the resultant R stands for the magnitude of the resultant. R of the forces makes an angle alpha minus theta with the direction of the force P plus Q, with the direction of the force P plus Q. Therefore, the formula will be applied here. What formula? If P and Q are the forces, the angle between the two forces P and Q is alpha. The resultant makes an angle theta with the force P. Then tan theta equal to q sin alpha divided by p plus q cos alpha. Thus the applied formula. Therefore tan alpha minus theta will be equal to q sin alpha, means q means here it is p minus q, q sin alpha, sin of the angle between the two forces, sin alpha, the angle between the two forces is twice alpha here, divided by p plus q cos alpha. For p you will have to write p plus q, for q you will have to write p minus q, cos alpha, for alpha you should write cos 2 alpha. Thus we have written according to the formula. This means, what is tan alpha minus theta? This is equal to tan alpha minus tan theta divided by 1 plus tan alpha into tan theta. You see, sine twice alpha. What is sine twice alpha? Twice sine alpha into cos alpha divided by 1. For 1, if you write cos square alpha plus sine square alpha, sine 2 alpha means twice sine alpha cos alpha divided by cos square alpha plus sin square alpha. Now divide the numerator and denominator by cos square alpha. You will get twice tan alpha divided by 1 plus tan square alpha. For sin twice alpha, you may write twice tan alpha divided by 1 plus tan square alpha. Now p plus q plus p minus q cos square alpha means cos square alpha minus sin square alpha. Cos square alpha minus sin square alpha divided by 1. For 1, write cos square alpha plus sin square alpha. Therefore, cos 2 alpha can be written as cos square alpha minus sin square alpha divided by cos square alpha plus sin square alpha. Now divide the numerator and denominator by cos square alpha. You will get cos 2 alpha equal to 1 minus tan square alpha divided by 1 plus tan square alpha. Write this, 1 minus tan square alpha divided by 1 plus tan square alpha. Like this. You get this one. Or you will get 2 times of p minus q tan alpha divided by p plus q tan square alpha plus p minus q tan square alpha. No, I am sorry, p plus q into 1 plus. You will have to write 1 plus tan square alpha. 1 plus tan square alpha plus p minus q 1 minus tan square alpha. 1 minus tan square alpha. right? Now, this means this is equal to, in the left hand side, it is same, tan alpha minus this one. 2 times of p minus q tan alpha. Here there will be 4 plus 4, 8 terms. 1 into p plus q, 1 into p minus q. P plus q plus p minus q. Plus p minus q. 4 terms has been written. Plus p plus q minus p plus q into the square alpha. Four terms with the square alpha. Four terms without the square alpha. Plus q minus q cancel. Here plus p minus q will be cancelled. This means 2 times of p minus q tan alpha. Twice p plus twice q tan square alpha. Tan square alpha. Now 2 will be cancelled. 2 will be cancelled. This means tan alpha minus tan theta divided by 1 plus tan alpha into tan theta should be equal to. This should be equal to p minus q tan alpha divided by p plus q tan square alpha. P plus q tan square alpha. This is equal to p tan alpha minus q tan alpha divided by p plus tan alpha into q tan alpha. You may write like this. Now divide numerator and denominator by p. This is equal to tan alpha minus q by p tan alpha divided by 1 plus tan alpha q by p tan alpha. Divide numerator and denominator by p. You see here tan alpha minus tan theta, 1 plus tan alpha into tan theta equal to this. You compare left hand side and right hand side. You compare left hand side and right hand side. In the left hand side, tan alpha, right hand side tan alpha, and in the numerator minus, minus. In place of tan theta, it is q by p tan alpha, and compare the denominator also. In the left hand side 1, in the right hand side 1, plus, here it is plus, tan alpha, only tan theta has been replaced by q by p, tan alpha. If you compare the left hand side and the right hand side, then you will find that in the right hand side, tan theta has been replaced by q by p, tan alpha, right hand, nothing else. Comparing both sides, we will find that tan theta equal to q by p tan alpha. Comparing both sides, we get. Comparing, we get. Comparing both sides, we get. We get tan theta equal to q by p tan alpha. Q by P tan alpha. This means P tan theta equal to Q tan alpha. Proved. We have proved this one also. If you compare carefully, you will find that in the left hand side, tan theta, if you replace tan theta by Q by P tan alpha in the left hand side, you will find the right hand side. Therefore, tan theta is equal to q by p tan alpha. Therefore, p tan alpha is equal to q, p tan theta is equal to q tan alpha. We have proved question number 18. Therefore, let me remove this one. Question number 18 has been proved.
Answered.
Now, let us come to question number 19. What is it? If the resultant of the forces P and Q be equal to depth, that means the resultant of the forces P plus M, S and Q plus S.
If the resultant of the forces P plus Q be equal to depth of the forces P plus S and Q minus S, it should have been Q minus S.
Q minus S. Just correct the question. Q minus S.
Acting at the same angle, then find the magnitude of the resultant. Then find the magnitude of the resultant. Now let me this one.
Question number 19. Let the angle between the forces P and Q be alpha, therefore the angle between the forces P plus S, L, S and Q minus S is also alpha. Let the angle between the two forces. Solution to the question number 19. Let the angle between the forces P and Q. Let the angle between the forces P and Q be alpha.
Therefore, the angle between the forces P plus S and Q minus S also alpha.
Therefore, the angle between the forces P plus S and Q minus S is also alpha. Also alpha. According to the question, therefore, according to that question, equal, the two forces are equal. P square plus Q square plus twice PQ cos alpha should be equal to P plus S whole square plus Q minus S whole square plus twice P plus S into Q minus S into cos alpha. Same thing. S is not equal to Q minus P. We have to find the magnitude of the resultant. We have to find the magnitude of the resultant. This means P square plus Q square plus twice PQ cos alpha equal to P square plus S square plus twice PS plus Q square plus S square plus minus twice QS plus 2 times of PQ minus PS plus QS minus S square into cos alpha. Right? Now P square will be cancelled. Not only there, Q square will also be cancelled. Q square will also be cancelled. This means twice PQ cos alpha equal to twice S square plus twice PS minus twice QS plus twice PQ cos alpha. PQ cos alpha plus 2 times of QS minus PS minus S square into cos alpha. You will get this one. Now, these two terms will be cancelled from both sides. These two terms will be cancelled from both sides, and at the same time, two also can be cancelled. 0 equal to S square plus PS minus QS plus QS minus PS minus S square into cos alpha. S square into cos alpha. This means 0 equal to S. S plus P minus Q. S plus P minus Q S. S plus P minus Q cos alpha. Cos alpha. Which is equal to S into S plus P minus Q 1 minus cos alpha. You may write like this. You may write like this. Now, this is equal to 0. In the left hand side, it is 0. Left hand side, it is 0. Now, S is not equal to Q minus P. This means S plus P minus Q is not equal to 0. This term is not equal to 0. Also, S is not, also, S is not equal to 0. If S is equal to 0, what is the meaning of this question? S is not equal to 0. This means that, therefore, suppose this is number star, therefore star implies, this implies 1 minus cos alpha equal to 0. This means cos alpha equal to 1. Cos alpha equal to 1. Means, we have to find the magnitude of the resultant. Therefore, the magnitude, let R be the magnitude of the resultant. Let R be the magnitude of the resultant. Of the resultant. Therefore, R square equal to P square plus Q square plus twice P Q cos alpha. Twice P Q cos alpha. This means R square is equal to P square plus Q square plus twice PQ. Since cos alpha equal to 1, apply this result, cos alpha equal to 1. This means R square is equal to P plus Q whole square. R square is equal to P plus Q whole square. This means R is equal to P plus Q. This is the magnitude of the resultant is P plus Q. Therefore, the magnitude of the resultant is P plus Q. Answer is P plus Q. We have done question number 19. Now, come to question number 20. What is it? If the resultant R of the two forces P and Q inclined to one another at any given angle, makes an angle theta with the direction of P. Then show that the resultant of the forces P plus R and Q acting at the same angle will make an angle theta by 2 with the direction of P plus R. The direction of P plus R. What a question. If the resultant R of two forces P and Q inclined at an inclined to one another at any given angle. Suppose this. Resultant of P and Q. You may write the vector sign here. OA, CB. OA, CB. The resultant of this will be this. With the direction of P. The resultant makes an angle theta. And suppose that the angle between the two forces, this is twice alpha. No, not twice alpha, suppose this is alpha. This is alpha. AOB, this angle is alpha.
and the resultant makes an angle theta with the direction of the force P.
Vector sign has not been given. This means that the magnitude of the force is P. Then show that the resultant of the force is P plus R and Q acting at the same angle, P plus R. Now you produce OA to OD, OA to OD, BC to CE, suppose. CE in such a way that it is R, it is also R. The resultant of OD stands for P plus R. OD stands for P plus R. This will be again Q, right? The resultant of P plus R and Q will be this one. Suppose this is R1, resultant of this is R1. We have to show that it makes an angle theta by 2. We have to find this angle is theta by 2. First, try to understand the question. Then we shall try to solve the question. First, try to understand the question. Two forces, P and Q, acting at the point O, the resultant is OC. The resultant is OC. OC makes an angle theta with the direction of the force P. Now, we produce, what is OC? Equal to R. We produce OA to OD such that OAD distance equal to OC distance. There then OD will represent the force P plus R. Also, at the same time, CE has also been produced, BC has also been produced to E, such that BE, it will stand for P plus R. Now we shall join DE. This force is Q. This force will be again Q because it is a parallelogram. The opposite sides are parallel and equal also. Therefore, the new resultant is OE. The new resultant will make an angle theta by 2. We have to show that this will this angle will be equal to theta by 2. Theta by 2. Perhaps you have understood the question. Solution. Let the forces P and Q. I have given here the vector sign. In the question, the vector sign was not given. This means that the magnitude of the force P is P, magnitude of the force Q is this Q. Let the forces P and Q be represented in magnitude and direction by the sides OA and OB of the parallelogram. OACB. Therefore, by the law of parallelogram of forces, therefore, by the law of parallelogram of forces, law of parallelogram. Parallelogram of forces, the resulting R will be represented by in magnitude and direction will be represented in magnitude and direction by the diagonal OC of the parallelogram. OC of the parallelogram OACB. OC of the parallelogram OACB. This means OA, this factor is equal to P, OB equal to Q, OC, OA equal to P, the magnitude, OB equal to Q, OC equal to R. Not only that, BOA, let BOA, this angle is equal to alpha, at an angle alpha, at a given angle alpha, COA equal to theta, the resultant makes an angle theta with the direction of the force P. It is given, COA equal to theta, it is given, because in the question it is given that the resultant of P and Q makes an angle theta with the direction of P. Therefore, you will get this COA equal to theta. Now we produce. OA to D and BC to E such that AD equal to OC equal to CE equal to R. AD equal to OC equal to CE, this is equal to R in magnitude. Therefore, OD will represent, OD equal to P plus R. OD will be equal to P plus R. BE, equal to BC plus CE equal to P plus R. Will be equal to P plus R. OB, is parallel to DE. Also, OB equal to DE. Therefore, OB equal to DE, it will represent the force Q. This will represent the force Q. Right? Now, this will represent the force Q. Therefore, by the law of parallelogram of forces, OE, the diagonal OE, will represent the resultant of P plus R and Q. Therefore, by the law of parallelogram, you see the diagram, ODEB is a parallelogram. OD represents the force P plus R, and OB also represents the force Q. These two sides are the adjacent sides of the parallelogram ODEB. Therefore, by the law of parallelogram of forces, they are diagonal. OE will represent in magnitude and direction by
magnitude of the magnitude and direction, the resultant of the forces P plus R and Q.
By the law of parallelism of forces, thus you may write OD represents. OD represents. OD represents the force P plus R. The force P plus R. You may write the vector sign also. OB represents the force Q. You may write the vector sign also. Represents the force Q. Therefore, by the law of parallelism of forces, by the law of parallelism of forces, OE will represent OE forces the diagonal OE of the parallelogram. Diagonal OE of the parallelogram. ODEB. ODEB will represent the will represent in magnitude and direction and direction in magnitude and direction the resultant of the forces P plus R and Q. P plus R and Q. We have written if the vector sign is not given, then you should understand that the magnitude of the forces has been given. OE will represent the resultant of this. The resultant, suppose this is R1. We have written here R1. Now we have to find the angle EOD, this angle. And we show that this angle is equal to theta by 2. This angle is equal to theta by 2. Now, from the triangle, OCE. OCE, this triangle, OC equal to CE equal to R. OC equal to CE equal to R. Right? This equal to R. Therefore, if two sides of a triangle are equal, the opposite angles will also be equal. This side, the opposite angle is this. This side, the opposite angle is this. These two angles will also be equal. This means COE should be equal to CEO. Should be equal to CEO. These two angles will be also equal. Now you see angles will be equal. This. Now O, D and B E, these two sides are parallel. O D and B E. OE is transversal, OC intersects
the two parallel sides OD and BE. Therefore, this angle should be equal to this angle because these two angles are alternate angles. Now, OD is parallel to BE. OD is parallel to BE. OE is transversal. OE is transversal. OE is transversal. Therefore, DOE, DOE, this angle should be equal to BEO, BEO, because alternate angle. Alternate angle. Interior alternate angle. Now, here CEO, CEO is nothing but BEO. You may write here BEO also, because CEO can also be written as BEO. Suppose this is number one and this is number two. From one and two, BEO, BEO, DOE, DOE should be equal to COE. Should be equal to COE. 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 DOE should be equal to COE. Suppose this is number 3. Now, COE plus COA. This angle is theta. Now, COA. This angle is theta. Now, COA. This angle is theta. Because the resultant R makes an angle theta with the direction of the force P. It is given. Therefore, this angle is theta. COA can be written as COD. COA can be written as COD. Angle is theta. This means COD. COD can be written as COE plus EOD. This is equal to theta. This is equal to theta. COE can be written as DOE. DOE plus, it is again DOE equal to theta using 3. Using 3, you will get this one. Using 3, you will get this one. DOE equal to COE. EOD means DOE, same thing. COE has been replaced by DOE. For here, EOD has been replaced by DOE. This means 2 times of DOE. The angle. 2 times of the angle DOE. Equal to theta. This means DOE equal to theta by 2. What is DOE? This means that the angle between the resultant and the force P plus R. That is the result, that is the angle. That is the angle between the forces
between the result and resultant R1 of P plus R and Q. Resultant of P plus R and Q of resultant R1. The angle between the resultant R1 and P plus R is theta by 2. This means that the new resultant makes an angle theta by 2 with the force, with the direction of the force P. This means that the new resultant What is the new resultant? Resultant between P plus R and P plus R and Q. New resultant. You may write in the bracket that is the resultant of P plus R and Q. The new resultant, the resultant of P plus R and Q makes an angle theta by 2 with the direction of P plus R. Makes an angle theta by 2 with the direction of P plus R. The resultant makes an angle theta by 2 with the direction of P plus R. Perhaps you have understood this. It is obviously this. Simply, I want to tell you OA represents the force P, OB represents the force Q, their resultant is OC by the law of parallelogram of forces. And it is given that the resultant makes an angle theta with the direction of the force P. With the direction of the force P, the resultant, this makes an angle theta. This angle is theta. This angle is theta. Now, we produce OA to D, OD and BC to CE such that O D equal to P plus R and B equal to also P plus R. This is R. This means that OC equal to CE equal to AD equal to R. Now OCE, consider this triangle OCE. This is R, this is R. Therefore their opposite angles should be equal. This angle is equal to this angle. Now, OD and BE are parallel lines. This intersects it. This is the transversal. Therefore, this angle equal to this angle. This means that the three angles are equal. What? This angle, this angle, this angle are equal. Means that these two angles are equal. This means OE is the bisector of the angle. What is this angle? This angle is theta. Therefore, it is theta by 2. This is theta by 2. But OE is the resultant of the forces P plus R and Q. Therefore, the resultant of P plus R and Q makes an angle theta by 2 with the direction of the force P plus R. This is the this is the case. Therefore, the resultant of the forces P plus R and Q makes an angle theta by 2 with the direction of P plus R. Perhaps you have understood this. Dear students, I want to stop here today. Thanks for attending the class. Thank you very much. Thank you.